वेलकम स्टूडेंट टू क्लास 5 मैथ्स। लेट अस कंटिन्यू चैप्टर नंबर 2 व्हिच इज एडिशन सब्ट्रैक्शन एंड देयर एप्लीकेशन। स्टूडेंट इन द फर्स्ट सेशन यू हैव सीन हाउ टू ऐड द लार्जर नंबर, सेकंड सेशन यू हैव सीन हाउ टू सब्ट्रैक्ट लार्जर नंबर। टुडे इन दिस पर्टिकुलर सेशन वी विल डू एडिशन एंड सब्ट्रैक्शन word problem, that means their application. I have seen students are very scared of word problem. Are you also? Word problem are nothing but an integration of your English and maths. Now English means what? Student, you have seen unseen passage. It's same. Just read the question from the given instruction. And maths, you already know just to do the calculation and find the answer. Let us approach today the word problem on addition and subtraction. Now, here we have to remember few points. First point, we must read the question carefully before solving them. Now what is our rule? Now here we add. When we add, when a quantity increases by the given amount, or when we have to find the sum or total of the given quantities. When these two types are given in the question, this information is given in the question, then we are supposed to add. What are that? To find the sum or total, or when a quantity increased by the given amount. When such information is there in your question, then we are supposed to add. Now, to subtract. We subtract when a quantity reduced by the given amount. Student, if you see here, increase word is there. So when a quantity increase, we add. When a quantity reduce, we subtract. Or second, to find out how much is left. Here the word left, when the word left is there, we are supposed to subtract. Third point, when we have to find out how much more or less a quantity is than other, when here comparison is there, whether it is more or less, then we are supposed to subtract. When we have to find the difference between two quantities, when we want to find out difference, we are supposed to subtract. So you have to remember these four points. When such four points is there in the question, we have to subtract. Like quantity reduce, left, more or less a quantity is than other, and the difference. When these four words, if it is there in the question, any one out of these four, then we have to subtract. Understood, student, that in the word problem, when we have to subtract or when we have to add? When you remember these points, it's become very easy. Let us exercise 2.3. Solve the following word problem. Question number 1. Now see, student, what is given? Let's read this. This is unseen passage like for you. A movie hall sold 69,385 tickets in January. Now see, a movie hall is there, and in movie hall in January month, 69,385 tickets were sold. 56,392 tickets were sold in February. And 4,692 tickets were sold in March. Now, student, if you see here, in January month tickets they have given here, in February month and March month. In 3 months they have given us the how many tickets were sold. Now, what is the question here? How much tickets were sold in this 3 months? What is given here? This information is given, that 69,385 tickets were sold in January, 56,392 were sold in February, and 4,692 tickets were sold in March. And they have asked how many tickets were sold in 3 months. Now this 3 months, so what we are supposed to do here, we are supposed to add. Okay, now see how to write down solution. Now see, first line, sold here, sold ticket in January. So we'll write down tickets sold in January. So we have written here the number, how many tickets were sold. Now next is tickets sold in February. We have written it one below to other. And next, tickets sold in March. See here, it is 4,000. So we have written at 1,000 place and 692. Now what we are going to do, we want to find out tickets sold in 3 months. So tickets sold in 3 months means we are supposed to. This student, remember the answer to the word problem must always be written in a statement form. What we are supposed to do, the answer, finally answer, we have to write down in word problem. To this word problem, the answer must always be written in the statement form. So we'll write down question number 2. A city has 629,480 men, 432,958 women, and 738,201 children. Now, what is given in this statement? A city has, that means in a city, number of men is 629,480, number of women is 432,958, and number of children is 738,201. And what we want to find out, what is the total population of the city. Now here what is given? Total. When here total is given, that means we have to add. Let's write down the solution. Number of men, we have written here number of men 629,480, number of women 432,958, number of children 738,201. Now we'll write down here total population of the city. Total population of the city means we are supposed to add, and children, you know how to add this. Come on, let's start doing addition. Okay, now just check your answer. Yes, just check whether it is right or wrong. Just see here, 0 plus 8 plus 1 become here 9, 8 plus 5 become 13, 13 plus 0 will become 13, 1 carry over here. Now 2 plus 9, 11, 11 plus 4, 15, 15 plus 1 with this carry over become here 16. Now 8 plus 2, 10, 10 plus 9, 19, 19 plus 1 become here 20, so 2 will be here carry over. 3 plus 3, 6, 6 plus 2, 8, 8 plus 2, 10, so 1 will be carry over and 0 will be here. And 7 plus 4, 11, 11 plus 6, 17, 17 plus 1, 18. So your total population of the city is, come on children, you have already learned how to read the large number. So it is what, see if you see this is 100, this is 1000 and this is lakh. So your answer is 18,639,000. So final answer we'll write down in a statement form. So your answer is, thus total population of the city is 18,639,000. Now let's come to question number 3. Question number 3 is, Mr. Ahuja spent rupees 9,50,000 to buy a shop, rupees 19,000 to get the wood worked, and rupees 2,20,000 on electrical fitting. How much did Mr. Ahuja spend in all? Now student, what information is given here? That Mr. Ahuja is going to buy a house, and he buy that house for 9,50,000. Now in that shop he is going to do some wood work done that he has done for ₹90,000, and he is doing some electrical fitting for 2,20,000. So what they have asked, how much did Mr. Ahuja spend in all? In all means including buying a shop, woodwork done and electrical fitting. That means we are supposed to add here. So let's write down the solution. Amount spent on buying a shop, we have written here 9,50,000. Amount spent on woodwork done, we have written here 90,000, one below to other. Then amount spent on electrical fitting, 2,20,000. See children, all the numbers we have written one below to other. And finally what we have to write down, amount spent in all. So what you are supposed to do, plus, and then start adding. So what is your addition here? 0 plus 0 plus 0 will become here 0. 0 0 0 will become here 0. 0 plus 0 plus 0 will become 0. 0 plus 0 plus 0, 0. Now 2 plus 9, 11. 11 plus 5 will become here 16. 1 carry over and 6 here. 9 plus 1, 10. 10 plus 2 become 12. So your answer is this. So how we will read this? This is, see here, 100. This is 1000 and this is lakh. So your answer is 12,60,000. So Mr. Ahuja spent in all how much? 12,60,000. So finally we'll write down our answer in statement form as, thus total amount spent by Mr. Ahuja is 12,60,000. I hope student you have understanding well. Come on, let's do question number 4. Question number 4. What is the total of 45,60,909 and 54,66,999? Now student, this is very simple question. What they have asked? Total. Now total as in means what? It's, you have to do sum. Sum means you have to find out, we have to do the addition of these two numbers. So directly now we will solve it. Solution, total of these two number, we'll write down this in a horizontal form. Also we can write down, and then vertical, or directly you can write down in a vertical form. So we have written this. So we'll write down here plus, and just solve this. Student, you know to add. Come on, do it fast and then check your answer. Start solving.
Hello. Good morning.
Yes. Just check your answer. See here, 9 plus 9, 18, 1 carry over here, 9 plus 0, 9, plus 1 carry over 10, 9 plus 9, 18, plus 1, 19, 6 plus 0 becomes 6, plus 1, 7, 6 plus 6 is become here 12, 4 plus 5, 9, plus 1 become here 10, 5 plus 4, 9, 9 plus 1, 10. So children, you know to read large number. Let's read this. This is 100, this is 1000. This is lakh and this is crore. So your answer is 1,27,908. So final we'll write down answer in a statement form. Thus the total of this two given number is 1,27,908. Okay, let's do the next one. Now what is given student here? In fifth one, an organization distributed food to 21,39,819 children in December month. 39,57,055 children in January. To how many children was distributed food in all? Now this question they have asked, to how many children was food distributed in all? And what information is given? That there is an organization, they are distributing food to the children in December month to 21,39,819 children, and in the month of January they have distributed food to 39,57,055. Means 55. Now, our question is what? Distributed food in all. In all means what? We have to find out the total number of children that organization has distributed food in the month of December and in the month of January. So, I hope students you have understood now what to do here. When in all is given in the question, you are supposed to add. Let's write down the solution. Food distributed in January, we have written here food distributed in December also we have written. Now, only January and December month is given. So we have written, now we'll write down that food distributed in all. So we are going to add and student, just solve it. And now just check your answer. So 0 plus 5, 5, 9 plus 5 become 14, 1 carry over, 8 plus 0, 8 plus 1 will become your 9, 9 plus 7 become your 16, 5 plus 3, 8, 8 plus 1, 9, 9 plus 1, 10, 3 plus 2, 5 plus 1 become 6. Come on children, just copy down the question, answer. I hope you are doing with me. So let's come to the next question. Sorry, thus an organization distributed food to. Finally, answer we have not written. So your answer is in statement 4. Thus an organization distributed food to 60,96,945 children. Now let's do next question. Question number 6. Now what is question number 6? How much should be added to 5,23,980 to get 7,37,000. Now, see, how much should be added? Means there should be some number that should be added to this to get this number. Now, student, I have told you how to check the answer. When it is told to check answer, that down answer and final answer. This is your final answer. And in this, if you subtract this, you will get the upper number. So what we are going to do here this final answer is given and one number and another number is added. So we don't know what is that another number. So what we'll do from this final answer, we will subtract this number, whatever answer you will left that you will get it. So let's write down number to be added. We have written this is big number minus small number. We'll write down this in a vertical form. Yes. Now children, you know how to subtract this. 0 minus 0 will become 0. This 0 minus 8 we cannot do, so we have borrow from here. Again, 0 minus 8 cannot do, so we have borrow from here. So this from 7 it will become 10. This 10 will given here 10, so this 10 become your 9 and 7 become your 6. Now 10 minus 8 is 2, 9 minus 9 is 0, 6 minus 3 is 3, 3 minus 2 1 and 7 minus 5 2. So this is what 2,13,020. This number should be added to 5,23,980 to get 7,37,000. Now this we'll write down in a statement form. Thus 2,13,020 should be added to 5,23,980 to get 7,37,000. Let's write second question. Now student, come on, write down the question. By how much is 2,35,296 greater than 1,59,260? Now see here, 2,35,296, this number is greater than 1,59,260. Now see, there is a comparison in between these two numbers. And when there is a comparison, what we do? We subtract bigger minus smaller. So we'll write down your solution. That 2,35,296 is greater than 1,59,280. And we'll do here subtraction. We'll write down in a vertical form and we'll borrow, regroup wherever is required and we'll get this answer. So your answer is 0. Your lakh place is given 0. So this we will not write. So this is 1000 plus 76,036. So here, thus 2,35,296 is greater than 1,59,260 by 76,036. I hope student you have understood this question number 1 to question number 7, what we have done word problem. You have understood it very well. In the next session we will continue the remaining sums. Thank you.